Yeah. Hey guys, welcome in. I'm glad you guys are here. Come cook with Joe. Tonight we have got some bone-in pork chop with Alabama style barbecue sauce, which is a white barbecue sauce. Well, I will here in a second. Which is non-traditional. We've got that with green beans that we're going to char a little bit, and some apple slaw. So I'm really looking forward to it tonight. It should be pretty fun. Hopefully it'll be a nice full meal that you can amaze your friends with. I'm going to give you some tips on how to get some nice grill marks on your pork chops. Hopefully you guys are able to go out and get some. So tonight, which way do I need to go?
I don't know yet.
Okay, hold on a second, folks. I'm sorry, technical difficulties. Can you see everything okay?
Yeah.
Okay. So tonight I've got the pan back here, the 9-inch round pan for the green beans. I've got our grill plate. I'm not a big grill guy outside, but I do have a grill plate, and this is a brand new plate that I'm so excited to use. Seasoned nicely. My mother-in-law bought it for me for Christmas, and so I'm really excited to get into that. So we've got a plate here with some paper towels, and that paper towel, what we're going to do is we're going to dap off the pork chops once we get them ready, and we're going to set them. We'll get to that step here in a few minutes, but if you have some paper towels and a good plastic plate, go ahead and grab that, because that's going to be on the raw pork chop. So over here we have a bar full of product. So we've got our cutting board and, of course, our knife. We have a Granny Smith apple, which I ask you guys to pick up. Some green beans, which I bought a whole bunch of green beans, so I'm going to actually do some probably on Saturday, old Southern style green beans with some ham hock and everything else. But I went ahead and tipped off some of those for me and Kim tonight. We've got our mayonnaise. I've got two different size bowls. One's going to be for our, what was the one for? One's for the slaw, and the other one's for the white sauce. I've got salt, pepper. I've got our mayonnaise. I have a whisk. I have a 1 tablespoon measuring spoon. I have a cup, because we're going to need a quarter cup of the mayonnaise whenever we get to it. Dijon mustard, our monstrous pork chops. Guys, we found these pork chops on sale at our Kroger's for 99 cents a pound. We have 6 chops in each package, and roughly they're about $3.50 some cents. It was crazy. So we picked up 3 packages. We've got almost, well, we do have 6 meals apiece. Back there. So that's kind of exciting. We've got our coleslaw mix, which I just picked up the Kroger brand. Now, if you want to do your own slaw mix, you can get your head of cabbage and some carrots and just shred those up. I usually do that by hand. This is going to be convenient tonight. Food processor. Well, I use food processor. I do it by hand, but I'm just saying, this is the 16-ounce bag. We only need 8 ounces of this tonight. So if you've got this bag from Kroger's, make sure that you're only using half the bag. We've got our sugar, our apple cider vinegar, and then we also have our olive oil. And then I've got my plates for plating. So let's go ahead and jump into this. The first thing we're going to want to do first is go ahead and get our veggies ready. So if you haven't already, or maybe you bought canned, I don't know, but if you haven't already, go ahead and take your green beans and just snip off the ends. Memory is of grandma sitting around with a big bucket. And, you know, we used to get the half runners with the strings, and we used to just peel those and then, you know, break them down. So these, unfortunately, were just the green beans, and so we was able just to break those tips off, and we're good to go. So the first thing we're going to do, Granny Smith apple. So we're going to have to core this out, so we're going to go ahead and slice it straight down the middle, all right? And then, again, we're going to cut that into quarters, all right? So now we have a quarter. Then I'm going to come in here and cut the core out, okay? And then we've got our trash bag there. So we're going to go ahead and do that with all of these first, okay? We're going to go ahead and core them out, so we won't have to worry about that anymore. So that last piece, last half, we're going to go ahead and cut that off and core it. And core that half. Okay, now we have quarters of our apple, of our good Granny Smith sour apple. So now what we're going to do is we're going to come in here and we're going to make cuts at about 1/4 inch. Because what we want to do is we want to matchstick these, or julienne cut. Mm-hmm. And now that we've got them cut like that, we can bring them back here and lay them on their side. Might want to separate those to make the middle even. And then we're basically just going to cut those down. And now we have matchsticks or julienne cut, We have julienne apples. So we're going to do that with all these quarters here. And then that's going to go into our slaw mix. So basically what you can do is you can go ahead and grab your bowl for your slaw mix and just go ahead and throw those in so you can see what those look like. All julienne cut, nice and thin like matchsticks. So that's kind of cool. So I hope everyone's had a good week. Mine's been pretty decent so far. I've been a little bit slow, but it's nevertheless just part of the time, I guess. So just trying to make some lesson plans for my students once they get back. And that's kind of exciting. And you guys were able to be here with me during this time so I can make these videos and I can take these in and show the students. So that'll be kind of cool too. Well, not take them in. I guess it's on YouTube. I can show them on YouTube. Okay. So I hope everyone's holiday weekend was really good. I know ours was good. We actually got a chance to sit back and relax, which was kind of nice. I don't know if everybody got a chance to jump on Facebook and see our date night with our hashtag adventure date, but we was told to go out and buy a picnic basket. And then we went to, we didn't buy a picnic basket, did we? We went to a hobby store and we bought a basket. And then we bought the, what's that?
We went to Michael's,
yes, because it was on a Sunday. So we went to Michael's and picked up the our basket. And then we came home and we did a sort of a charcuterie board and went out back and was nice to sit there under the tree and have a nice picnic. So that was pretty fun. So hashtag adventure challenge if anybody's looking for some fun stuff to do with their significant other or their families, because they also have a family edition, which is kind of fun. So the total time on this tonight says it's going to be about 30 minutes. So that's usually about what I try to do with you guys. I want to show you that you can make some real good quality meals in a short period of time. So from prepping to everything else to the table, it doesn't take you guys that long. And making food and cooking for your family should be relatively easy and fun. Get everybody involved. It's a good time. So Kim usually helps me whenever we're in here by ourselves. Of course, there are some times that she says I have my chef talk on, my chef voice. And then, right, then she goes and sits and plays a game because she's like, well, fine. I'll go do my thing. So excited about tonight because football season is back, and that will be really fun, I think. So, all right. So now we've got all that together. We've got our green beans prepped, so it's ready to roll. So we don't have to worry about anything of those unless you need to cut off the tips. Then go ahead and get that started. So now what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and season our pork chops and get them dried off. So we're going to take our pork chops and set them right here on this paper towel. One. Like I said, these things are monstrous. Two. Almost doesn't fit the plate. Get rid of this bag. And then I'm just going to take the other paper towel and just fold it over. And I'm just going to pat that dry.
I don't know why I'm on the same blah.
Blah what?
I don't know.
So Cindy is saying blah something. So I've got salt and pepper. So we're just going to go ahead and bring that in here and salt and pepper both sides. So salt one side and pepper the one side. We're going to flip those over. Carefully. These things are so monstrous. Let me wash my hands real fast. So working with pork, the one thing you want to remember about pork. Oh, blah for football. Okay, Cindy's upset that football's coming back on, I guess. She's blah, blah, blah. So, all right. So with pork, the one thing you guys want to remember is that pork needs to be cooked to an internal cooking temperature of at least 145. That way we'll make sure it gets done. So we're going to salt and pepper the other side now. So beef is at 155, pork's at 145, chicken's at 165, and fish is at 135. So, okay, got that set. We're going to leave that alone. So, and let that set for a few minutes. So now what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and make the slaw together.
You need to turn your oven on to get your pan on.
Which pan, huh?
The one you're going to grill
your pork chops on. I guess I can. No, not yet. Let me go ahead and get the slaw together. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and take our bowl that we had. And I'm going to take half the slaw mix. Well, actually, no, I'm not. I messed up. So let's go ahead and take our apples, and let's go ahead and lay them back here on our cutting board. I forgot I need to whisk all the wet ingredients together. Okay, so now what we're going to do is we need 2 tablespoons of our apple cider vinegar. I know the recipe called for 3, but we're only going to put 2 in the slaw mix. So there's 1. And there's 2. I'm going to go ahead and set that back over here. Okay, so we've got that. We need 2 tablespoons of oil. So I'll go ahead and grab that and throw it in. There's 1 and 2. And then we also need 2 tablespoons of sugar. Now, with this, guys, I'm just going to basically eyeball. So I'm going to go ahead and take the sugar out and add about 2 tablespoons of sugar. Okay. And get that out of our way. All right. Now, I've got my whisk here. Thank you, honey. We're going to whisk that together. Now,
my mom says, of course, you're not going to measure anything.
Cindy's upset that I'm not measuring the sugar. Well, I told you what it was, though. So it's 2 tablespoons. So you can't give me too much for that one, so. Riley's underfoot.
As always.
Yes. Okay, now we can take, let's go ahead and get this over here. Now we can go ahead and take our green apples and slide them back in. Like that. And then we're just gonna toss that, get everything well incorporated. That looks and smells amazing. Cindy said I was just teasing, and actually it is what it is. I usually don't measure. I wanted to make sure I got it right tonight though. So, all right, let's go ahead and drop this here. Okay, now we got our slaw mixed. So now what we can do after that point in time, you know what? Let's add a little bit of salt and pepper to that slaw. Now, of course, guys, again, this is the taste. So you should always taste your product as you're cooking. I know I usually never do because I'm just trying to get through the process with you guys. So a little bit of salt and pepper. That's good. We're going to leave that there and set it aside. And now we're going to get our pork chops ready. So grill plate, we're going to go ahead and get that turned on. So I'm going to use that on a medium-high heat, even though we are cooking on a cast iron. So we're going to go ahead and get our cooking spray and spray that down real good. I did. Yeah, I told everybody whenever I first started cooking. So another shout out goes to Cindy for making this great purchase for us. So.
Your mom said she is splendid and it's delicious. So she wants to take a bite of the slaw.
Oh, good. So I'm glad you take a bite. So my mom used Splenda instead of sugar. Keto friendly, good thing. And she said it's really good. She said it's delicious. So glad to hear that. So that's a good thing. So what we're going to do now is we're going to go ahead and once this grill plate gets hot, we're going to go ahead and get our chops on and we're going to let those grill. Again, medium high heat, spray the grill with the cooking spray. We're going to drizzle the chops with some olive oil here in a second. And then we're going to throw those on the grill plate and get those cooking 4 or 5 minutes on each side. And again, guys, like I said, I'm going to teach you how to do the grill marks. In case you don't know how, hopefully it can give you a good tip, make it a real, real pretty presentation. So what we're going to do whenever we do that is we're going to think of our grill as a clock. And so we're going to put the tip of the chop at 10. And then after it cooks for about 2 or 3 minutes, we're going to take that and turn it to 2. And then once that cooks for 2 or 3 minutes, we're going to flip it over and do the same process on the other side. And that'll give you those nice crisscross grill marks, which is really pretty. And so that'll be really fun to do too. So the crosshatch grill marks really is nice for presentation. So we'll go ahead and get these on the grill then. So what I'm going to do is go ahead and grab my tongs. And again, you're going to want that tip at 10 o'clock, just like that. And we're going to take the other chop. I'm just going to use my fingers and wash them. And do the same thing. So tip at 10, all right? So again, after that cooks for a couple minutes, those start sizzling for us, we're going to take those and turn them to 2 o'clock. And then after that gets done, we're going to flip them over, and then we're going to take 2-3 minutes and then flip them back, all right? And that'll give us those good hash grill marks on there. So I'm going to wash my hands real fast because I touched raw pork. And then we're going to go over and start working on our Alabama sauce. Kim and I took a trip just this past June down to Alabama and found their Alabama sauce, and it is amazing. It is so good. So hopefully this will turn out good for us tonight as well. So we're going to need our other bowl right there. I'm going to go ahead and take these green beans and set them over here because this is where we're going to cook with them. So, okay, so we're going to need a quarter cup of mayonnaise, 1 tablespoon of the cider vinegar, and then a teaspoon of the Dijon mustard. So we're going to go ahead and grab our mayonnaise and throw a quarter cup in. Once I can find my quarter cup. Where's my quarter cup? There it is. Nope. There it is.
The bottom.
Well, I knew it was the bottom. I just couldn't find it. It was hiding on me. Okay, quarter cup of mayonnaise. So I've got my handy-dandy little rubber spatula here. I've got my glass measuring bowl. Okay. Now we need a quarter cup of Dijon? No, we need a teaspoon of Dijon. Teaspoon of Dijon, and then we need about a tablespoon? Tablespoon, yes, it was the last one, wasn't it? So we called for 3 tablespoons, the apple cider vinegar. So the last tablespoon will go in. Now guys, your consistency on this, you are gonna want about the consistency of a good salad dressing. So what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and get this mixed in, and if it's too thick, we're going to add in a quarter teaspoon of water at a time until it thins out. So actually, I'm going to add a little bit more mayonnaise to that. Thicken it up a pinch. So I hear our chops sizzling over there on the grill plate. Yeah. Okay. Checking on the chops. So we're going to add a little bit of pepper to our sauce. About a quarter of a teaspoon will do you.
You said you're chopping up the sauce.
Huh?
But you said add pepper to your chops.
Oh, I'm sorry. I meant the sauce. I was thinking about my chops. Okay. So, got these cooking. So now what we can do here is we can go ahead and turn those. So we're going to go ahead and grab those and flip them. Like I said, we're going to go to a... Not flip them. I'm sorry. We're going to go to a... 2 o'clock. Just like that. 2 o'clock. Just like that. Now we're going to let those set and cook. I'm going to get rid of this paper towel. Now, while the chops are cooking, go ahead and get it ready for our green beans. So what we need is a tablespoon of olive oil. So we'll bring this over here. Yes, they do. Kim said it smells really good. So we're going to go ahead and throw those on, and I'm going to get that burner turned to a medium-high heat. I'm not used to using my back ones. We're going to let that heat up. Now, of course, once we get our pork chops done, we're going to let those sit and rest. Because remember, guys, we always let our meat rest. And we're going to let that sit and rest for 5 minutes. So during this process, what we're going to do here is once this gets done, we're going to go ahead and pull those to the side. And we aren't going to plate them yet. We're just going to pull them to the side. So we'll allow the green beans to cook. But about the time the green beans get done, everything should be pretty much about finished. And we'll be ready to plate. So. Oil's getting nice and hot. Pork chops are smelling amazing. We've got our sauce. We've got our slaw mix. So there's our sauce. So that'll be good. And then we've got our slaw mix. So that's good. Pork chops are cooking. Oil should be hot, so I'm going to go ahead and add these green beans in. And get those started. Now, the green beans, we're going to add the green beans and cook for about 3 or 4 minutes or until lightly charred and tender. And then we're going to season with a little bit of salt and pepper, and then we'll be set with those. So, so our green beans up just a pinch. Okay, now guys, I'm going to go ahead and treat this and turn it. So we're going to turn it over and again put that point up to the top. Point up to the top of 10. So, Mom said Dad won't eat the slaw, which she's excited about because she said she's excited about eating it. And then she said, what about? Oh, she was just going to fix him some slaw with mayo. Good stuff. What's that? It could be. Had to turn my vent on. The smoke is going pretty good. I've got some chops that want to turn or curl up on me. It just all depends. I want to make sure they get cooked. My green beans are starting to snap, which is fun. Yeah, should have used that, huh? Didn't think about it. Yeah, it's all right. Okay, again, we're going to take that and turn it to 2. Oh, good. And Kathy said she's got her slaw. She said it looks good. Our green beans are starting to char, which is good. All right. Now, guys, I'm going to do something I normally don't. Grill wasn't hot enough, so we didn't get a lot of good marks on one side, so I'm just going to take it and flip it back over. Now, if you can see, though, the grill marks are really nice. So you've got that hash cross on the grill. This side's really good, too. So I just, whenever I started cooking them, they sort of bubbled up on me, and I didn't get the one side really good and charred. So, all right. What's that? A lot of steam? Oh, sizzling, yeah. Yeah, we've got, Kim said there's a lot of sizzling. We've got the green beans that are getting charred, and then we've got our pork chops that's cooking. So.
Jeff said, good job, Joe.
You said Jeff?
Okay.
Hey, Jeff, it's good to see you. So remember, whenever you flip these, you either want them at 10 or 2. And that way you don't get contradicting marks on them. Those are about done, though. Green beans are getting good and charred. So we will pull those here in a second. I'm going to go ahead and pull those chops here in a minute, too. Still got a little bit of blood running out of them, so I'm going to let them cook a little bit longer. Then turn off my green beans. Let them simmer. These monstrous pork chops are just, they were crazy. All right, I'm gonna kill the fire there, and I'm gonna go ahead and pull these chops off, pour them off. I'm gonna let them go ahead and rest right here on this plate for a few minutes. And get some hot gloves so I can move it. All right. Green beans are charred, so those look really good. I'm going to turn this back off. Have to get the windows open here in a few minutes. So let's talk about plating. All right. So plating tonight is going to be a little bit different, guys. First thing we want to do is we want to get a serving down of the green beans and the slaw. So I'm going to take some green beans, and I'm going to put a serving down of the green beans on one corner. And then I'll put another serving of green beans on the other plate. Try to divide them between me and Kim. Mm-hmm. smell good, don't they? All right. Now we've got our green beans down. Come back over, and we're going to grab our slaw mix. How are we going to do that? Yeah, probably a good idea. Grab some tongs, baby ones. And we're going to put a serve in that slaw mix there on the other corner of the plate. No, right? Yeah, because it's all going to be together, huh? All right. Obviously, we got some more there. All right, now we're going to take a little bit of our barbecue sauce, and we're going to plate it right here on the front. Now we're going to come back with our pork chops. Pork chops, not for sauce. I'm going to take those pork chops and lay them right in there. Mm. They are big. Thank you, Kroger's. Look at the juices on that. Lay that right back in there. Get rid of this plate so I don't make a mess. All right, guys, here we go. We have bone-in pork chop with Alabama barbecue sauce, some charred green beans, and some Granny Applesmith slaw. So a complete meal. I don't think it took very long. What time are we at?
I don't know. It doesn't say.
Oh, it doesn't say. So we'll have to look at the time here in a little bit.
We started at 5 minutes, a little off.
Okay, so we're looking roughly about 30, 33 minutes. Yeah, so that's not too bad. So hopefully you guys enjoyed. I'll turn you guys around so we can get the send-off. Hang on to your seat so I can spin this thing. All right, not too fast. So again, guys, I appreciate you coming in. It was a fun night. It was a really good meal. Again, you guys enjoy this with your families. Next Thursday, we'll be looking for something to do. A couple more weeks and I'll be on intercession. So I'm really excited about that one. So maybe we can do a little bit more elaborate stuff on the last couple weeks of the month. Other than that, you guys have a great week and I'll see you next time.